Alright, hello and welcome back to Let's Play Mega Legends 2. I am SIMSteven, also known as Ms. Fenrel, and we are in the end of the Neo Ruins this time. Just kind of picking up where we left off, and I hope everyone had a good Memorial Day weekend. I kind of didn't record over the weekend because I wasn't even at home. Anyways, made it to the final room at the end of the last episode, and Data is obviously there at the end of the ruins. Got two boss fights before we get out of here. Yeah, two, even if we're in the last pit. That's the little key room. So, there it is, right there. Let's go, just take it. We got the second key!
You did it! You got the second key!
Just kept on saying that.
I don't believe it. Bola lost to a little punk like you? Ha! If you think I'm a pushover like Bola, you've got another thing coming to you. I work for a living. I don't hold back ever. Not even if I have to fight a little kid like you. You're not getting past me. Not as long as you have that key. If you aren't going to hand it over nicely, I'll just have to take it from you.
Hey, it's Fat Albert. Actually, no, it's Klaymoore. Or, as some of you Battle Networks fans like might call him, NightmanEXE. Thing about Klaymoore here is he is not hard at all. Look at him, he's just standing there. I could probably show off some of his attacks, and I probably will in the video, but this is just the easiest way to beat him. You just get right up to him. Bam! Drill arm.
Not bad for a kid. You're not such a pushover. I haven't had this much fun in a long time. You wait. I'll be back.
And as you may have guessed, when he says, I'll be back like the top of that time, we'll be seeing him before we get out of here. So yeah, second boss fight will be him again. I'll actually have to walk out of these ruins, unfortunately. Yeah, they did it for Manda, where they just teleported you out of there. They did Forbidden Island, where, once again, you got teleported out once you were done. And the same thing with the mines, even though they weren't that long of a ruin. These are the first ruins in the game where you actually have to walk all the way back out. And they had to pick Neo Ruins. Yeah, Water Temple Ruin. They have to force you to walk all the way back to the surface. Fortunately, playing aside, Neo Ruins are very easy to navigate when you're just going out. So it won't take us long at all to get out of here now that we've got the key and everything is unflooded and all that. So, just kind of got to mention one thing. Data disappears after that first fight with Bola. So we have to fight him twice. Not Bola, Klaymoore. We have to fight Klaymoore twice and we don't get to heal up in between. So the only other way we'll be able to heal other than our energy canteen is with killing reader bots and getting energy cubes out of them. So, man, I am having trouble with these platforms. Just a note here, these platforms are much easier to climb if you use a D-pad. Just hit D-pad down and circle, and you'll automatically do a 180, and you'll be able to turn around. You also want to go towards the edge of the platform before you do the turnaround, because that'll allow, because MegaMan will usually take a step backwards, and that step backwards is based on how hard you press the down button, or how long you'd press the down button before you hit the circle button to do the 180. I don't need to go there because I busted that down in the drill arm. Klaymoore is kind of an interesting character. Might as well talk about him since we just encountered him. Klaymoore and Bola, the pirate boss from the last ruins, are partners, and Klaymoore is the heavyset dude, obviously, because he can barely even move in that armor of his. I mean, he just stands still the entire fight and pretty much takes any hit that's thrown at him. Therefore, that makes it a very easy boss fight, because if you have the drill arm, which you should by now, you can just run up to him, use the drill arm, and kill him. No problem whatsoever. I just kind of toyed around with him a little bit. I could have gone straight up to him and killed him with the drill arm. Been done with that fight in about 5 seconds flat. Yeah, even on very hard mode with the huge life bars that the bosses have. Let's see, get some of the Zenny, since I don't want to let it go all the waste. How much have we gotten in here, by the way? Almost 100,000, which is decent. I can get a lot more from the King Mirak, obviously, because, well, I probably talked about him in every single episode since we met him, so, yeah. But yeah, Klaymoore and Bola are partners, pirates, and if you remember the intro scene where Glide was saying, but they are veterans, remember, Teisel? That's who Glide was talking about, because Bola and Klaymoore were in on just trying to get this mother load and all this Forbidden Island stuff from the very beginning of the game. So they're already there right from the start. It's just Bola was kind of off somewhere, probably taking a nap or something, while Klaymoore was that big dude in the suit on the sulfur bomb. But yeah, we're almost out of here, actually. We're on the third floor now. And this whole video so far is 7 minutes long. Other interesting tidbits about Bull and Klaymoore is that their names are based off guns, like most of the characters in Legends and MegaMan series as a whole. Bola gun is a type of gun that shoots a type of snare for wildlife to capture them alive. It's basically three weighted balls that are attached by a rope in the center, and when they wrap around the leg, when the gun is fired, they will wrap around the leg of an animal and prevent them from walking, allowing people to capture them for things like zoos or medical purposes, wildlife conservation and all that. So yeah, that's what the kind of gun that Bola is. And it's kind of interesting that we fought him in the most nature, the ruin that has the most nature in it, the grass or foresty type of ruin. Basically the Earth Temple, if you're going along with Zelda-like terms and all that. And those guys burned me bad. Thankfully, these guys usually give a lot of energy cubes. So I'm going to kill these guys for some energy cubes, just so I have enough for the Klaymoore fight. Another thing about Klaymoore is his name is based off not a gun, but a Klaymoore is a type of device used by snipers, where typically snipers will camp out in various locations, and they'll stay there for a long, long time. And what they'll do is to protect themselves, because they have to lie motionless for a long, long time. A Klaymoore is a mechanical device which they'll place typically behind them. And so if someone comes up on them from behind, it'll shoot a large chunk of shrapnel at anyone who comes behind them. And it's a way to protect themselves in case they've been sniffed out when they're trying to wait for their target that to come to the line of sight that they attempt to assassinate. So yeah, that's what a Klaymoore is. Aside from that, Bola and Klaymoore are kind of more like Mega Man and Roll in the respect that they're more focused on experience. And Mega Man and Roll are also considered to be pirates, at least in the Legends terminology of the Legends world and all that. But they are essentially good-natured pirates, because pirate is a term for Legend that applies to pretty much anyone that has an airship and does dangerous work and goes from island to island, typically doing digs. How it also applies to Mega Man role, well, it's just kind of a name, even though they're more digger-centric. They don't raid towns or anything like the other pirates that we've met so far. So Bull and Claymoore, I don't know how much shade business they've done in the past, because there's not a whole lot of information out there about their backstory, so that's kind of an unfortunate thing. Something I obviously would love to have seen if The Legends 3 had come out, just kind of give more story to characters like Bull and Claymoore, who have a semi-important role in this game, but I mean, you only fight Bola in the Manda Ruins and Claymoore here in the Nina Ruins, and you fight them twice, and that's all you fight of them. Anyways, I think we're back at the surface. Only 11 minutes into this video, and it only took about 5 minutes to get back up here.
I thought I told you to wait! I didn't think you'd gotten this far. A little more, and I would have lost you. Okay then, ready for another round?
Ready for another drill in your back? Half his life already. Drilling, drilling, drilling.
You're pretty strong, aren't you? That's a big gun you've got, but it's not enough to hurt me. You kids, do they think you're so hot? Well, there's still some fight left in this old man. My back. Ow, 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 ow. I can't move. Help me. Somebody, help me.
I thought I was supposed to be your partner, not your nursemaid. We're willing to call it a draw if you are, boy. Come on, Claymoore. Let's go.
If it weren't for my back, I'd have wiped up the floor with them, I tell you.
Yeah, whatever you say.
Claymoore. Interesting thing about Claymoore is he and a lot of other bosses here in Legends 2 are essentially, you don't want to use the circle strafe technique on a lot of bosses in Legends 2 because they designed the bosses to be a lot harder in Legends 2 compared to Legends 1, so you can't use the circle strafe on every single boss. Claymoore, if you actually want to fight him without using the drill arm, I don't know why you'd do that, but I suppose for a challenge or something like that. Claymoore will actually shoot in front of you if you're trying to circle strafe him, and he can start comboing you like crazy. So yeah, that's just one interesting thing about Claymoore is, if you're trying to shoot circle strafe and fight it in that way, you have to come up with a different strategy and probably go back and forth. Let's see here. Do we have any new items in the gym shop? No. I think I need to turn in the key first before I get more items in the gym shop. I suppose the rest of this episode will be getting set up for the next ruin. The next island, I suppose. Probably going to be a lot shorter than some of the other videos I've done recently for Legends 2. I suppose on the way back to the Sulfur Bottom, I will also say one more thing about Claymoore that I like about his character. Claymoore, if you listen closely to everything he says, he pretty much always says everything in everything he says is pretty much a cliche phrase. I mean, you got another thing coming. I'll be back, you wait. And stuff like that. So it's like, everything he says is like old movie lines that have been done to death. And so yeah, it's kind of funny. Anyways, roll saying, should take it to the, take the key to the Sulfur Bottom. First and foremost, though, since we got all three of the present items, I'm going to give them to Roll. First, I'm gonna start with the doll. Thank you, MegaMan. It's so cute. I just want a doll like this. Your little cushion. Thank you. It's so soft. Can't wait to use it. And the silver bottom model. Well, thanks. I can't wait to see how it lies. Okay, so now all we have right at this point is to develop and move. Didn't tell you before about a new toolkit. I got lots of tools to make it easier to and cheaper to improve your weapons. Yeah, this does not happen until after you give her all three present items. And what that does is it decreases the cost of all weapons upgrades by 10%. So, suppose between this episode and next episode, I'll upgrade the hypershell, which we got the end of the episode two episodes ago or so. I'm gonna see how much is it gonna cost to get a couple upgrades. I'm gonna save some of this Zenny just in case the parts shop has some new items. Oh, and now that we've done that, we get a special scene. Now we've given her all the three of her gift items and spoken to her in the development room. Data will say there in the cockpit of Flutter that Roll's gone to take a bath. So, just like in Legends 1, there is a scene where you can walk into, like the scene where Roll was changing your clothes. The screen goes dark.
Egg! What do you think you're doing?
Capcom, you sly dogs, you. So we walked into her when she was taking a shower. I might as well take a picnic lunch while I'm here. Okay, what's the headlines news say, by the way? Digger's Guild defeat pirates. Clyde's getting the hacks beaten off by Digger Guild members. Aw, what about me? A brand new TV. Maybe someday we'll have something. Yeah, that's all it ever says, even though you have to buy that. I suppose to get all the upgrades in that room. Yeah, nothing important about the TV, but let's go check Roll's diary since we've done that little nosebleed scene, I suppose. The cushion that we give her, actually it will appear right here, by her little couch thingy. Sure feels good when someone uses a present you gave them. And the stuffed doll is this penguin. Looks like really... Roll really likes the stuff. It's been hugged many times. In the sulfur bottom model, it's something you can actually jump on and fly around, and it will carry around the room backwards. So, kind of just a fun little thing there. We haven't really gone through a lot of Roll's diary. Might as well do this, since read through a lot of these entries, since we're kind of about a third of the way to... somewhere between about a third of the way and halfway through the game at this point. And I went looking for Joe together. It's first time to go on a dig with MegaMan. Those robots are scary. Yeah, it's way back at the mines. I haven't checked the diary here since we did just before we went into those mines. I'm glad MegaMan was there to protect me. I'm so lucky to have him around. As I mentioned in an episode or two ago, if you're mean to Roll and shoot her down a lot when you're escorting her across the Oshoka snowfield, it'll say something different. I think it says something like, the rear bots are scary, but MegaMan's buster gun is even scarier. I got hit so many times, I thought he was aiming for me. And you also got to see that whole scene you get if Roll's on her bed about an episode or two ago. So, yeah, I suppose interesting. My father? We got a dropship from Joseph in Yonka City. Funny thing is, it looked like the dropship my father designed all those years ago. We weren't able to talk to Joe for too long, so I couldn't ask him anything about it. I found one where he knows. It looks like we're the first key is in Pocky Village on Mid Island. This is our first dig in a while, so I'm a little nervous, but I'll try my best. After all, MegaMan's depending on me. Thanks to MegaMan, I was able to repair the living room. You finally able to sit down and eat again. Now all we need to do is get a new TV set. And we got a new TV, of course. Looks like that trauma or whatever name was saying bad things about me to MegaMan. I'll have to ask him what she said later. Yeah, it's the scene where Tron was imitating Roll with that voice synthesizer thing back in Pakti when we fought her there. Thanks to MegaMan's donations, the village of Pakti, which was destroyed by the monsters, has been rebuilt. Maybe with such nice person always helps people in trouble. I wish more people could be like him. And we got the first key. It's hard being a supporter and not able to see anything, just relying on sensors. I'll try harder next time. I won't be able that much. How much more we gotta go? We have to get the first key to von Blücher safely. I'm always made every time to see that ship of his. Maybe one day I'll be able to build my own ship like that. That glide was one of our toughest opponents we've had to face. The base somewhere on Calbania, and we'll have to go there next. I know we shouldn't worry, MegaMan could still take care of himself, but I hope he doesn't get hurt. Aw, she cares about us. MegaMan was able to rescue Appondaw. Be able to help Appondaw rescue Sipir. I never mentioned people were living on that island. Yeah, this is that line that I was talking about before, where it wasn't thought that anyone was living on Calbania Island, and that's also evidence that it may have been reinitialized in Shu, Apo, and Da were possibly clones made by the Carbon Reinitialization Program. To New Island. Now the glide's out of the way. We can get inside the new rooms. I wonder what we'll find there. Yeah, almost done. Second key. We got second key. Megaman's gotten even stronger than I imagined. I'm so proud of him. Maybe I can't go with him on digs, but I can do my pipe. Part by designing new weapons for him. So yeah, not only does she does spotter work, she also makes our weapons and stuff. So that's how she participates in this whole digging business of ours. Megaman gave me a stuffed animal today, a penguin. I've always loved penguins, the way they swim through, like they were flying through the water. Now you think about it, there are no penguins on Forbidden Island. I wonder why. There was no life on there to begin with, except for whatever Yuna had sealed in those stasis changer pairs. MegaMan gave me a cushion today. I feel a little guilty, so he gave me things and I haven't given anything back. It's just soft and very comfortable. I could use it when I'm working the designs or watching TV. Thanks, MegaMan! Take it. MegaMan gave me a model of silver bottom about 1/200th scale, but it looks like the real thing. There are some places that could use some more detail. If it doesn't matter, later, me, I'll weather it a little. Thanks, MegaMan! MegaMan walked in on me while I was in the bath. We hadn't talked too much. Haven't talked much to each other since then. I'm sure it was an accident, but he did something like that about a year ago. Now that I think about it, all the rule 34. what if he's doing it on purpose? I don't know what I would do. What I would do if he is. Anyways, that's kind of up to date with the diary. I don't want to go too far without reading through some of those entries, but since this isn't going to be a long episode, might as well do that here. Let's see here. I think we should get the key to von Blücher as soon as possible, but tell me if we want to do something else first. Let's see. I definitely want to grind some more Zenny here on Manda between this episode and next one, because I'm going to want to upgrade that hyper shell. Something I've never actually mentioned to, because it keeps slipping my mind. If you see in the top corner, top of the screen, whenever you are hovering over a point that you can land, you can see the name of the island and the city, the major city of that island. So we're on Nino Island. Ruminoa City is the name of the place that the Guildmaster works and all that here on Nino Island. Interesting thing about this, Calbania Island, Calbania Plains. Should also mention, if you save on Calbania Island, it's listed as Carlbania. Just a bit of mistranslation on that. Green Island, no city there. Kalinka Island and Yoshonka City. So I've been calling it Yoshonka because I forgot the name of the island for the most part of this let's play. An island, Pakti Village, and just the silver bottom. No island there to name. So, anyways, let's just head over to von Blücher's office, hand over the key, and get our next assignment. Good work, my man. Do you meet the good master? How is he? Both Beryl and I go a long ways back. Go back a long ways with him. We had many adventures together. Hey, once it's all over, we can get together again and catch up. Anyway, on to the next key, we should be able to find an unsolved Kada Island. The city there, Kimotoma, is famous for gold statues in the city center. We're getting word that our old friends, the Bonds, are already there. And one of the best lines in the game. indeed, the reports say that they've already begun exploring the ruins. Your mission there is to free the city from the group of the pirates, then find the key in the ruins and bring it back here. Good luck, my man. Okay, anything new you got to say and tell me about the next island? Statue on Saul Kada. That statue has great historic and cultural value. It's just hope the pirates haven't damaged it. Yeah, they plan to steal it and all that. The ancients. We've got the ancients in one of the guest rooms. The key, they haven't done or said anything since then. Since the pirates don't know they're here. We should go try talking to them. They might know something useful. Okay, so you can see that the second key is now in place in this room. Yeah, convenient little addition he made just for us, of course. Of course. He's got all that money, you know, even though that was there as soon as we got back from Finden Island. Plot convenience, of course. Let's go talk to Geets and Sarah. Not Gats, the one that I was playing as in the room, but Geets is the other one that serves Sarah here, not Yuna. Once all four keys have been collected, the Great Seal will open, and you will be able to find the Motor Lode we call the Great Legacy. What do you call the Legacy? Okay, so I think he's saying the same thing as before. Yeah, same thing. Just think there's another mystery to solve. Same thing as before. I remember them saying something different at some point in the game, later. Probably... I think it's before you get the fourth key, or just after you get the fourth key. I'm not entirely sure, but it's later on that they'll change what they say. And I'm pretty sure of that. Anyways, now we've gone through another story event. Let's see if the junk shop has anything new. The Super Ball! That's the other item I've been needing for that one... part that I've been having for like half the game now. Flameberry, I definitely want to get that before I go to the next ruins. Link armor, definitely want that. 50% damage reduction. Obviously better than 25% that I have with the padded armor. Link armor, yep. I want that. Anything else worth getting? Oh, yeah, definitely want to get that, and I'll be able to farm the King Merrick a lot faster once I get that, because should be able to max out my power, and that's what the main stat I'll need to find the King Merrick, and make things go a lot faster when I do. I should probably also go to a general store and see if they have anything new. And... I don't know if I've checked the vase here. Like I said before, when you buy the vase, it'll go into Beryl's room, and if you check it, it'll have some Zenny in it, but unfortunately, I must have already gotten the Zenny out of that thing. Probably off screen or on screen, I don't remember. But we're about ready to end this episode off here. We're supposed to go to Saul Kada Island next, boy. Hey, how the place is, be sure to bring your suntan lotion. Yeah, that's kind of a hint that we have the fire temple next. In a desert, of course. So yeah, Saul Kada Island is essentially Africa of this world map. Like I said earlier in one of the early episodes, this landmass here is kind of like South America / North America. This landmass here is kind of like Africa, specifically the Sahara Desert, if I remember. I think it's the Sahara Desert, the big part of North Africa. This is basically Australia, I mean, no one's living there, of course. no offense to Australian viewers if you're out there. And this is kind of like a Russia slash Europe slash tundra slash Siberia. That's why this thing is so huge, is because it is meant to cover a lot of area. And I think like the Middle East would have been right around here. If this is the entire Earth, which I highly doubt it is, especially since Mega Legends 3 revealed some sort of map, some sort of new island that is got a huge, huge skyscraper ruin kind of jetting out of it. And of course, Kalox Island isn't on this map whatsoever. We'll be visiting Saul Kada Island here next time, and be rescuing the city from the bonds. But I will be stopping off here and grinding some Zenny on that King Merrick. So I suppose I'll end the episode off here and call it a day. Even though there's not a whole lot for me to, haven't made a whole lot of progress. Did a few storyline events, beat Klaymoore a couple times, and well, that's about all I really need to do for this episode, just to get things set up, because next episode, Saul Kada Island is probably going to take 2 episodes at least by itself. So, just end things off here and call it a day. Thanks for watching.